check video right now. How about that? Can you see me? How many fingers am I holding up? Let's make us a Cajun meatloaf with an Italian twist. So we're going to do that. I got some stewed tomatoes. It says Italian style. And they got a whole lot more junk in here than just regular tomato sauce do. So we're going to take this and drain some of the liquid out of it. And then get the little motorboat out down there and puree it up and make us a tomato sauce. Go on top of that meat and loaf and meat. All right. Now I got some stale bread right here, a couple days old. Find your church key and open you up some evaporated milk. I don't want it to splatter everywhere. That's why I didn't want to put too much pressure on it when it's right by me belly. Go ahead and saturate this bread with that evap milk. This is rich. Got a good flavor. You ain't got that, just use regular milk. We ain't gonna need no eggs in this. We ain't gonna need no goat meal. No, that don't go in a damn meatloaf. That's for your breakfast. We eat grits down here. We don't eat no goat meal. I'm sorry. No damn cream of wheat either. That's non-union as it comes. So let's go ahead and get this bread all nice and moist with that evap milk. And this is your binder. You can also put some tomato juice in here if you would like to. And I should have done that. I should have drained out some of the juice from this. Maybe too late. We'll see. See, it's plenty wet. And it's going to sop up all that milk. And that's what we want. Down here in plate A, got some salt. I know you can't see it. Cajun season, garlic powder, Parmesan cheese, oregano, basil, and pepper, black pepper. And I grinded that pepper myself. You know I got a spice mill. So I'm going to go ahead and mix. This is real similar to my meatballs. Almost exact. Except with the following. You paying attention? Mix this all about first. Now, let's add some regular onions, chop onions, whatever color you like. Take the pretty garnishes off. And I got some bell peppers that I had frozen and already chopped, so I'm going to use them. Got some celery. I got some green onions. Shallots. Scallions. Not shallots. Shallots are different. Now we got to crush these garlic cloves up and get them down in there. Let me rinse my hands in the zinc. Garlic. I'm going to use a press. Come over here, good knife. Get all that good stuff off of there. And who would that? They trying to sell this device to get the garlic smell off your hands. Why? Man, that's fine. I love it. Lick your fingers when you're too fooling with it and cutting it up. Ain't nothing better than garlic. Yum, boy. Are y'all crazy? Whoever come up with that stupid ass idea? We already got garlic powder in there. Don't lose none of that, JB. You won't get all these little pieces up in there too. Come out of there, boy. That's what we want to see. See like that there? Let's mix all this about. Yum! You talk about smell good right now. Just soon fry this up and eat it. You could put crawfish in here. You could put shrimp in here right now. And make a meatloaf with that. Or stuff some bell peppers with this. You want to make it Mexican style? Put you some cayenne. Put you some cumin in here. Some chili powder. You have Mexican style meatloaf. Put it, make it any way you want. Put five spice powder in it, make it Chinese style or Mongolian sauce, teriyaki sauce. However you like it, make it your way. That's what cooking's all about, boy. All right, this is Cajun style, JB's way. Now, all them seasonings all thoroughly mixed in it, and worry the hell out of it. Now we gotta go get some ground meat and put up in there. Gotta wrench my hands off again. I hate losing all that seasoning too. Let's just save it. I done washed my hands about five times now. Oh, you know what? There ain't no egg in there, no raw egg. Tastes right. You want an otter? Cayenne pepper. Come over here, camera. Boy. I got some 85-15. And the reason I'm not using chuck in this is because we got to drain the grease out of it anyway. Because it's going to have a lot of fat come out of this meat, and you want to do that. You can also mix in half ground meat and half ground pork, if you'd like. You can also stuff this. We may just do that. Let me get this ground meat all mixed in there. Gotta take it out of that package first though, JB. Don't throw it in like that. A boy, girl, dog, cat, and tomboy. Now while I wasn't on camera, I went ahead and emptied the last little pieces out of that garlic press in this ground meat. Now it's time to worry the hell out of it. Let's get that done. That meat cold. Gonna make my little fingers get numb. Be all right. Making a loaf in meat. Meatloaf, boy. Come on, Cajun style. We're an Italian twist. And yet, they're going to have big chunks of vegetables in here. That's all right. That's good. Now, this much meatloaf ain't gonna fit in a traditional meatloaf pan. So we're gonna put it in a bigger pan, and we're gonna form a loaf. Loaf and meat. Ain't that something? I know you gals may get a giggle out of that one. So, putting the loafing meat over there in the pan. Let's go ahead and open up a little pocket in here. Oh, JB, what you gonna put in there? Well, you don't want to put nothing raw in there that may not cook. Damn, I gotta wash my hands again. I feel like a rocket surgeon now because this gonna be the fifth damn time I done washed my hands in the sink with soap and hot water. Now, what? Are you recording, stupid? Good thing. give you a whooping. Now, I spied with my little eye while I was in the refrigerator some pepper jack cheese, but I better not put that in there, Miss JB. I did find some just regular shredded cheddar. Let's go ahead and put that up in there. You got cheddar that's block cheddar, in other words. Put it in there too. And let's seal that up in there. You could put ham in here. You could put cooked bacon. Put smoked sausage in there. Something that's cooked though. Don't put nothing raw in there. All right. Y'all go on down in there. Now we gotta seal this boy up. Just like that there. Now we got us a stuffed meatloaf. Now you could also put cooked eggs, hard-boiled eggs inside of this. You could put asparagus, fresh asparagus. Something is cooked though. Beat that meat like that on top, huh? Oh, that was a bad choice of words, wasn't it? I'm sure the food police gonna come jump my ass for that. That's tough. I don't give a Seal it up good though. You don't want this dog to split open on you. Let's sew it up. Watch this here. Wash my hands again. Now I got some hardwood smoked bacon. Don't you know about that? Let's take this bacon that's gonna shrink and kind of lay it on there like that there. And another piece on there like that here. Oh, let's just let's not crisscross it. You talk about gonna give this a good flavor. Yes, sir, Marty. Come apart there, baby. You go over there. You come over here. Cajun meatloaf. See there? Now, if you really wanted to make it ultimate style, you could crisscross it the other way. But it's going to take long enough to cook like this here. So, we're going to cover this with some foil and bake it off in the oven and then uncover it. I'm going to wash my damn hands again, son of a bitch. I'm getting dishpan hands over here. Hold my zippers up this time. It better be. God damn, that water hot. Son of a bitch. Tip to you guys, if you're gonna make videos, don't touch your tripod with the fingers you're cooking with. Use the back side of your arm, or the bottom side of your hand. Dishpan hands. Sucks. All right, oven's hot. Let's dump these stewed maters in there. And puree them. Worry the hell out of them. I want you y'all to use these stewed tomatoes. Are you paying attention? Use the stewed tomatoes. Because they're sweet. They got an excellent flavor. Stew them yourself if you don't want to buy them in the can. Stand over there, boy. Don't fall down on me. Now go on and pour this on top. We're going to bake this off in the oven. And that meat going to release a wonderful juice. Trust me, boy. 350 oven. Fire. Stand by. I got that leftover juice in here. I got some ketchup. It's gonna be our topping. We got some pepper, black pepper. You want cayenne? Put cayenne peppers in there. You can do it. Make it hot as you want. Now normally I'd put brown sugar in this, but I see somebody that ate all my damn brown sugar. So we're gonna put some turbinado sugar in here, also known as sugar in the raw. Restaurant secrets. How about that, boy? I just tasted a little bit of this before I poured the sugar in, and it was like flavor explosion. I mean, with that amount of pepper I put in there. Shut up, timer! I know. Let me go get that loaf and meat out of there. Now, this don't happen too often, but I'm going to show y'all. I should have not poured that tomato sauce on top. I should have went ahead and let that bacon brown. So we're going to do that now. How now, brown cow? And we're going to get some of that tomato sauce that I'll scrape off the top. See there like that? And like that. And we're going to bake this uncovered to crisp that bacon up. Is this loaf? Shut up, timer! This loaf ain't ready yet. I am going to go ahead, however, and drain some of that grease out of there. There's a ton of grease in there come out of that grind meat. Let me do that and put it back in the oven. And there that meatloaf is, and it looks some good. And she made some mashed potatoes, huh?
Put this on there?
No, you go ahead and put that on your plate.
I'm supposed to go on top.
That's gonna be some fine. Let's see how that looks. Choosy. Yum. What that look like? She didn't even use a knife. I'm gonna do the spatula thing too. Give me a slice of that. Cheese. Oh yeah, it's stuffed with cheese. There's your gravy right there. And here's some garnish. Ain't that pretty? Here's some mashed potatoes that Miss JB made. Oh, I almost forgot the sauce. Gotta have the sauce on top. Put it on the side. It's a spicy ketchup sauce.